Alright, ladies and gentlemen, this is Sports Dom coming back with another video. And this is my Boston Red Sox at Arizona Diamondbacks Game 3 recap. So the Boston Red Sox beat the Arizona Diamondbacks 2-1 in this game. They clinched a series win. And for some reason, the best offense in the National League has gone ice cold. I don't know what it is. They had runners on base again yesterday and couldn't score them. I think this is the only team that gets the bases loaded with nobody outs like they did in game one and game three of that Philadelphia series and don't score. I've seen other teams get the bases loaded and clear them. The Diamondbacks, they get the bases loaded and then they just freeze. So I don't know what it is. And they strand a couple runners at third and second yesterday, but they didn't have the bases loaded at all yesterday, but they did strand some. They strand one at third. Ketel Marte hit a home run in the first to get the Diamondbacks on the board, 1-0, but that was it for their scoring. And then in the fourth, the Red Sox scored two, and that was it for them. The Red Sox didn't score a home run. Pavin Smith had four at-bats, one run. No runs, no hits, no RBIs, no walks, one strikeout, wasn't left on base, and has a .217 average. So they got to get him going again like he was last year. Him and Dalton Varsho were the best two on the team last year. Now Pavin Smith, I don't know what's wrong with him. Ketel Marte had four at-bats, one run, one hit, one RBI, no walks, one strikeout, wasn't left on base, and has a .277 average. So, Ketel Marte had a good game. And Corbin Carroll has gone ice cold for some reason. He had four at-bats, no runs, no hits, no RBIs, no walks, two strikeouts, wasn't left on base, and has a .278 ERA. So a lot, or average, I'm sorry, average. So a lot of these players' averages are going down because they're just, I don't know, they're ice cold. They got to win Game 3 and get their winning back. They're 29-23, 6 games above .500. They were 9 games. They lost 3 in a row. They lost the final game of the Philadelphia series and the first two at home against Boston. So I don't know what's going on. Christian Walker had three at-bats, no runs, one hit, no RBIs, no walks, no strikeouts, wasn't left on base, and has a .245 average. So they got to get Christian Walker going or move him. I mean, if guys don't want to score and don't want to hit, then they got to be moved. That's just, there's no other way to answer this. They got to be traded or cut. If they don't want to hit or score, they got to be moved. Lourdes Gurriel Jr. for some reason has gone ice cold. He had three at bats, no runs, no hits, no RBIs, no walks, one strikeout, was left on base once, and has a .310 average. So, hopefully today, he gets going again in Game 3. Josh Rojas had three at bats, no runs, no hits, no RBIs. No walks, one strikeout, wasn't left on base, and has a .248 average. So, and Gabriel Moreno, who was dealing with a tooth issue, had three at-bats. He had no runs, no hits, no RBIs, no walks, one strikeout, wasn't left on base, and has a .295 average. So, they stranded Gurriel at third on the one, and then they stranded Perdomo at third. Couldn't get him home. For some reason, with runners on base, this team just can't get him home. Jake McCarthy had three at-bats, no runs, one hit, no RBIs, no walks, no strikeouts. Wasn't left on base and has a .147 average. So I don't know what is going on, but Torey Lovello has to fix this. He's got to fix this, and because Colorado will chew him up and spit him out. Colorado will point at him and laugh at him and say that they can't score. You know, this team's going to get laughed at if this continues. So, Geraldo Perdomo has gone ice cold. Three at bats, no runs, no hits, no RBIs, no walks, one strikeout. Was left on base once and has a .304 average. Zach Davies, who took the loss, went 3 1/3, allowed 5 hits, 2 runs, 2 earned runs, no walks, 3 strikeouts, no home runs, and has a 5.68 ERA. So, they need pitching. They need hitting now. Kyle Nelson, who came in for Davies, went 2/3 of an inning, no hits, no runs, no earned runs, 1 walk, 1 strikeout, no home runs, and has a 2.25 ERA. So, I'm okay with his ERA. And then Tommy Henry coming out of the bullpen. He was moved to the bullpen to make room for Zach Davies. He went 1 1/3, allowed 1 hit, no runs, no earned runs, no walks, no strikeouts, no home runs, and had a 4.50 ERA. So, and then Austin Adams came in for him, went 2/3 of an inning, allowed no hits, no runs, no earned runs, no walks, 1 strikeout, no home runs, and has a 4.50 ERA. So him and Tommy Henry have the exact same ERA. So, and then Scott McGuff came in and went 2 innings, no hits, no runs, no earned runs, 1 walk, 5 strikeouts, no home runs, and has a 3.58 ERA. So that went down a little bit. He should have went a little longer, I think. But the Diamondback, they got today, they got to win game 3. They got to get their hitting back, because otherwise Colorado's going to come in here and take all 4. And then Miguel Castro went 1 inning. No hits, no runs, no earned runs, no walks, no strikeouts, no home runs, and has a 2.31 ERA. So, Ketel Marte in the bottom of the first hit a home run, which put the Diamondbacks up 1-0, and they couldn't get nothing else after that. Whitlock is the winning pitcher. Zach Davies took the loss, and Kyle Jansen with the save. So today it'll be Tanner Houck, I think, for Boston versus Merrill Kelly for the Arizona Diamondbacks. Houck is 3-3, has a 4.99 ERA. Merrill Kelly is 5-3, has a 2.98 ERA. So they got to get this winning back. They're 6 games above .500. They were 9. They lost 3 in a row. They lost the last game of the Philadelphia series, where Philadelphia came back from a 5-0 deficit to beat them 6-5 in 10 innings. They lost the first 2 at home to Boston. They got a win today, a win game 3 of this series. They already lost the series 2-1, and get ready. Tomorrow starts a 4-game series with Colorado. And then they got Atlanta coming in after that. So they got to win today. Salvage what they can of this series. Win game 3 and get ready for Colorado tomorrow on Memorial Day. So guys, comment in the comment section below on what you think. And as always, if you like my videos, like, subscribe, and hit that bell notification so you don't miss a video. This is Sports Dom. Peace. Go Diamondbacks. Let's win game 3 and take this momentum into the Colorado series. Get some hits. Score some runs today. And just get the winning back. Get the confidence back. They didn't look confident at all yesterday going up to bat. They got to get that back. Like I said, get some hits. Get some runs. Merrill Kelly has to go at least 7, so we don't have to use that gassed bullpen. The bullpen is gassed. They're worn out because we don't have a rotation that can go a long time. But stay tuned for my Boston Red Sox at Arizona Diamondbacks Game 3 preview and recap. And stay tuned for my Fayetteville Mustangs at Albany Empire National Arena League Week 8 recap. Another loss for the Albany Empire. So Stay tuned for that. Go Diamondbacks. Let's beat the Boston Red Sox. Win game three. Don't get swept at home. We can't lose four in a row and go to 29-24. Boston is 28-24. The Arizona Diamondbacks are 29-23. If we lose today, we'll have the exact same record as the Boston Red Sox. So win today and take this momentum of this win and take that momentum into the Colorado series. Go Diamondbacks. Beat the Red Sox in game three. Go D-backs.